Hey folks, welcome to InTheMoneyStocks.com's intraday analysis video, brought to you by the creators of proprietary price, pattern, and time methodology. Learn the PPT strategies and frankly profit for life, and today's no different, folks, as again I've been accumulating longs over the last week or so, and they are now paying dividends handsomely. And again, if you're a member of InTheMoneyStocks.com in the Research Center, which is our main investor service, you are banking more money, just like we were short in January or in early January. And again, started to take profits in late January. We started to accumulate longs over the last few days, and that is paying big dividends. All right, and again, great job. We see the market today rallying up 16 points, Dow up 137, NASDAQ up 36, and again, bouncing beautifully off of yesterday's lows. We were on the SPY, which mirrors the S&P 500, at 174 yesterday. Today we hit a high of 177. That's a beautiful 3-plus point move on the SPY, which is the equivalent to about 30 points on the S&P 500. And there's always detractors, and this is something I always want to say, folks, and it just gets proven over and over again. You know, when I was shorting in early January, people were saying the market would never fall. You know, people were even posting on this video, oh, the market's never going to fall. And it fell, and we made money, and those people probably lost a lot of money. And then when I was talking about buying a few stocks over the last days and going long and noticing that major stocks were into key levels and noticing that the market was probably going to get a bid here, at least for a few days, lots of people were commenting, oh, the market's going to go straight down. It's not going to bounce. It's going to go straight down. And this just shows that there's a lot of idiots out there, and it's either idiots or kind of people that just don't have a clue, and I encourage you to get educated. Because why should you be giving your money away? I mean, that's the bottom line. Why would you give your money away? Because you're just giving it away to the institutions. The institutions are just taking your wealth. When you're on the wrong side of the trade, they're just saying, thank you very much, because we suckered you in this way. Now we'll take it the opposite way, and then we'll sucker you in the other way and take it the other way. And that's what the markets are, folks. The institutions have a stranglehold on this market, and they'll push it until your emotions get the better of you and you do the wrong thing, and then they'll take it the other way. I know how to read that. And that's what I teach my members here at InTheMoneyStocks.com. So you don't have to be the idiot. You can be the one making the money. And again, just to give you some good examples, just one good one, PBR. All right, accumulated PBR right in this lower range right over here. Okay? And look at the run today, up 46 cents. Beautiful move there. Target, beautiful bottoming tail yesterday. All right, I talked about this in the video yesterday. Look at Target today on the daily chart. All right, look at Bed Bath Beyond reversing today. Look at BA, which I bought at 119.50 yesterday, trading at 122.22 today. So up $2.50 there. And I mean, I could go on and on, but it was just in the charts. And that's all I'm doing, folks. I'm not, you know, recreating the wheel, or I'm not doing anything nutty. I'm just reading the charts, and the charts will tell you. And the charts tell me that there will be significant downside in the future. There's no doubt about it. But why give back money by being short right now when the markets can bounce up and you could take some money on the long side and then reaccumulate shorts for the next rollover? I mean, that's how you make the big money. You know, when you're just holding and you're in the market for a year and it chops up and down and maybe you're up 10% or down 10% or whatever it may be, that's where you make the pennies. That's where the institutions want you to be. Because that way, you're really no threat to them, and they know if they push the market too far in one way, you're going to get out of your position for a loss, and then they can take it the other way, and you'll get back in and at the highs and vice versa. And that's how they just take what money you're making at your 9-to-5 job and transfer it right over to their profit zone, which, again, they're making billions of dollars every quarter, really. And, you know, half of that money is coming from trading profits usually. So don't let them do that. I mean, that's just the simple nature of it. Don't let them do it. Learn how to do this stuff, or, you know, come join in the money stocks, and I give you the trades, frankly. You know, I gave you Boeing yesterday. I gave you PBR. Okay? I gave you other ones as well. And they're there for the taking. They really are. All right. In any case, nice rally on the markets today. If we go back to the SPY here, and that's the daily chart, and you can see the daily chart getting a beautiful bounce. You should get a little bit more upside in the markets, probably to about the 178 to 180 level on the SPY. So you might even go back and touch 1800 on the SPY or on the S&P 500, but that's going to be where you're going to first hit some major resistance. So you know, start looking at this market with a little bit more upside. Honestly, if you're looking to get long now, you've missed the boat. I mean, take a look at Chevron. mean, Chevron was absolutely hammered the last week or two, and it's up $1.70 today. All right, huge, huge area. I mean, look at the fall it's had. It collapsed from all the way up here and came all the way down, and now it's getting a huge bounce. So you're too late on the, you know, if you weren't with us buying, it's too late. Just accept it, but then start to get ready to short the markets again at the right point, which we will give you the signal if you're a Research Center member. And by the way, there's a 7-day free trial, so you can easily get the 7-day free trial and find out exactly what we're saying here. Okay? So that's what we have going on in the markets, folks. Markets are hovering into a little resistance right now. Tomorrow's the jobs report. I think for the most part, the jobs report will be received well. You might say, well, how come? Well, honestly, everyone's expecting it to be kind of crappy because of the weather. And that's the beauty of it. If the jobs number is bad, folks, then they're going to say, oh, well, the jobs number is bad because the weather stunk in January. Okay, well, that's an excuse. And okay, so a bad jobs number would probably bring the markets down a little, but not that much. If it's a good jobs number, then they're going to say, oh, well, it would have been even better if the weather wasn't so bad. And then the markets are going to say, oh, it's great because the economy's doing better than we thought. And because the Fed is cutting QE, it's not so bad now because the growth is coming back. So I actually think you're favoring. Granted, the bounce today does take a little steam out of that. But I do think overall, downside is limited on a bad jobs number. And upside is there's decent upside potential there. I'd say there's about a 65-70% chance we head up a little bit tomorrow to a decent amount, and then there's about a 30% chance you pull back, but a pullback would be pretty minor from what I'm seeing. Okay, so that's where we're standing right there on the charts there, and again, let's just go over a couple charts today. Twitter is obviously taking a beating. Twitter had a beautiful pullback. So my business partner gives out gap plays in the intraday stock chat, which is our other main service at InTheMoneyStocks.com, and he gave out as a gap play before the market opened. He said, if Twitter hits $50, that's your buy point. That's a calculated out via an amazing calculation, proprietary calculation method that he uses. And guess what the low on Twitter was? $50 to the penny. And from that point, take a look at what Twitter did. So there are a lot of members bought it at that $50 level right there. That was $50 to the penny to his level that he gave out pre-market. Pre-market, he figured out that level. And he said, buy it right there. It hits it to the penny and bounces all the way back to $54. A $4 bounce on Twitter just like that. And then since then, it's kind of been in no man's land, but really an amazing move. And I got to give him credit for finding another perfect level, another absolutely perfect level. All right. What else do we have going on here? Let's take a look here. It's interesting to see, even with the market rallying today, IBB, which is it's one of the few shorts I have left actually out there, but IBB is down on the day, which is telling us that the biotech sector is on the weaker side. Some standouts today, we have GMCR, which signed a deal with Coke, GMCR. Stock's off its highs, but still up huge, tremendously. There's a lot of shorts in that stock, and this is why you can't short stocks. I only short mega caps or ETFs, all right, because then you don't have the risk of a buyout or a big deal influencing their service or their product, right? And that's why I would never short something like GMCR. I would never short First Solar, really. You know, the ones that are highly shorted that can be short squeezes, it's just too risky. You just don't do it. Smart money doesn't do it. I mean, that's the bottom line. If you want to play the options, that's up to you. But the key is you just don't do it with real money. And so if I'm shorting stocks, what am I shorting? I'm shorting like IBB, which is the biotech index. Okay, well, it's an index, so you're not going to get an index to be bought out. It just doesn't happen. Individual stocks can only be bought out. If I'm shorting a stock, I'm shorting a stock like Amazon. All right, there's no one's going to buy out Amazon. All right, and if I'm going to short a stock, it's like JP Morgan. No one's buying out JP Morgan. You see what I'm saying? And you have to analyze and trade and swing trade and accordingly and eliminate as much risk as possible. And that's smart money. That's what smart money does. All right, and that's how we make the money we do here. We keep the risk as low as possible. And it's not to say there's no risk. There absolutely is risk. But we keep it as low as possible, and then we can make some good money on the other side of the trade. All right, and right now, Spiders, again, up $1.75, hovering just underneath the 177 level, which again is a little bit of resistance. If you look here on the charts, in fact, I can erase this other line here, but see this little pivot low? Pivot low, pivot low, pivot low at 177. That's what we're hammering up under. So that explains why you're hitting a little resistance. I still think you get a little bit through that, and you could go as high as this area right up here, which is around the 179 and change level. But once you get in this range, that's where the market should start to top out again. Okay? I'm going to step aside, guys. I got to get back to trading, helping my members. But as always, it's a pleasure to be with you. And again, you know, start being the intelligent investor here. You know, I'm passing information along to you that's proprietary in nature. That's how I arrive at it. I'm willing to teach it. But again, you got to be willing to open up and listen to it and learn it. So better to do that and, and just continue to profit. I mean, you know, it was written on the walls, and I wasn't collecting longs over the last week or so for shits and giggles, frankly. You know, there's a reason why I was doing it, and paying nice dividends today. So we'll see, and we should see a little bit more upside, although jobs number tomorrow could be a little hairy, and we'll go from there. Take care, guys.